If you add up the number in each row, you get the power of 2. If you read the number from left to right, you get the power of 11. And when a two-digit number appears, we add the next digit of that number to the next number. Pick a number not on the boundary of Pascal triangle and look at the hexagon of the numbers surrounding it. There are two groups of alternate number in this hexagon. If you multiply the three number in each group, you will find their product is the same. Look at the diagonals. The first two aren't very interesting, all ones and their positive integers. But the number in the next diagonals are called the trigonal numbers, because if you take that many dots, you can stack them into equilateral triangle. The next diagonal has the tetrahedral numbers, because similarly you can stack that many spheres into tetrahedron. Imagine a circle with n point on it and lines connecting each pair of points. If you look at the nth row of Pascal triangle, then the second number represents the total number of points. The third number represents the total number of line segment. The fourth number represents the total number of triangles. The fifth number represents the total number of quadrilateral, and so on, until you reach the maximum number of sides. If we color on the odd terms, we see the Sierpinski triangle. If we sum these diagonals, the Fibonacci number shows up. To see pi, we look at the reciprocal of elements of the triangle. If you alternate adding and subtracting pair of elements of the third diagonal, you get pi minus 2. Now for E in Pascal triangle, we look at the product of number in each row and denote them with Pn. Now look at the nth row, multiply the two neighboring rows together and then divide this by square of middle row. Then this expression is equal to 1 plus 1 over n to the power n, which approaches to E as n approaches to infinity. We take the second diagonal, then multiply its first four elements and then multiply it with the elements of the fourth row and divide it with the product of element of third row. We get 4 raised to power 4. Similarly, when we multiply 5 numbers and fifth row and divide with the fourth row, we get 5 raised to power 5. More generally, we can write this. If we take the second diagonal and find determinant of first element, we get 1 raised to power 1. If we take third diagonal and find the determinant of first four element, we get 2 raised to power 1 plus 2. If we take fourth diagonal and find determinant of first nine element, we get 3 raised to power 1 plus 2 plus 3. And if we take the fifth diagonal and find determinant of first 16 number, we get 4 raised to power 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. Pick a 1 somewhere on the S and just go down diagonally. Then veer off at any point. So the sum of these number is equal to 10. We can do in other direction. So 1 plus 6 plus 10 equal to 20. Thanks for watching. Click here to watch the next video.